In 1803, the first convict station was established in Van Diemen's Land, later called Tasmania. Gradually, this lovely island became the most feared destiny for convicts, especially at Port Arthur and Macquarie Harbour. Sarah, or Settlement Island in Macquarie Harbour, acquired the reputation of being through Hell's Gate. Escape was impossible, they said. Pierce the Cannibal did it twice, overland, and ate his mates to stay alive. And Matthew Brady, everybody's darling, escaped by sea.
You certainly were a Bolter, Matthew Brady. You certainly were a wild colonial lad, admired by all the chaps and loved by every lady. And you very nearly drove old governor of the land.
He was born of Irish parents in 1799. He was ever so bloomin' handsome, and his manners were divine. But a terrible fate befell the boy somewhere along the line. You were pretty soon in trouble, Matthew Brady. They slammed him in the shackles when he forged his master's hand, shipped him on the Juliana to Van Diemen's Land. And poor old Governor Arthur just couldn't understand that you were everybody's darling, Matthew Brady. You certainly were a Bolter, Mr. Matthew Brady. You certainly were a wild colonial lad, admired by all the chaps and loved by every lady. And you very nearly drove old Governor of the Man. He escaped from Settlement Island, sailed out through Hell's Gate, betrayed by Thomas Kenton, supposedly a mate. But Brady slipped the bracelet, said I'll see you at a later date. You're in a pretty tricky business, Matthew Brady. Five of his men were dead. Governor Arthur ran rave, put a price on Brady's head. But Brady offered a keg of rum for the governor's head instead. You were certainly up and running, Matthew Brady.
You certainly were a Bolter, Matthew Brady. You certainly were a wild colonial man, admired by all the chaps and loved by every lady. And you very nearly drove old Governor Arthur mad.
But behaved so courteously. Then off to the captain pub to set the beer a-flowing free. Happy Christmas to you all, said Matthew Brady. But the funniest night of all was at the jailhouse at Sorel. He captured all the guards and troops and the magistrate as well. All the prominent citizens were locked in a tiny cell, and you rode up unmolested, Matthew Brady.
You certainly were a Bolter, Mr. Matthew Brady. You certainly were a wild colonial man, admired by all the chaps and loved by every lady. And you very nearly drove old Governor of the Man.
Brady caught up with Tom Kenton at the old Cocked Hat Hotel. Brady drilled him and that killed him, and that was just as well. For if ever there was a man deserved to be consigned to hell, it was the one who had betrayed you, Matthew Brady. But at last John Batman got him, they put Brady up for trial. Petitions galore from everyone, and that saved him for a while. Eventually they hung him, but he swung off with a smile. Oh, you always were a smooth one, Matthew Brady.
You certainly were a Bolter,
Matthew Brady.
You certainly were a wild colonial lad, admired by all the chaps and loved by every lady. And you very nearly drove old Governor of the Man. You certainly were a Bolter, Matthew Brady. You certainly were a wild colonial lad, admired by all the chaps and
and loved by every lady, and you very nearly drove old Governor Arthur mad.
You certainly were a bolter,
Mr. Matthew Brady. You certainly were a wild colonial lad, admired by all the chaps and loved by every lady, and you very nearly drove old Governor Arthur mad.
The bushranging careers of Michael Howe and Matthew Brady reinforced the fears of the British that the convicts might take over the colonies as the peasants had recently done in France. The decision was taken to create the ultimate deterrent, the prison which would feature brutality, torture, and terror beyond belief.